Hey, Jammers. I don't know about you, but I think dinosaurs are awesome. Now, we could sit here and talk about dinosaurs all day, but I have a certified dinosaur expert who is in the field right now, and he wants to ask us some questions. Wait, I want to ask him some questions. Let's see if we can beam him in right now. Joe, are you there?
Hi, Jammers. I'm Dr. Joe Peterson, a dinosaur paleontologist.
Thanks for joining us today. Can you tell us where you are?
I'm here at the Cleveland Lloyd Dinosaur Quarry, the biggest concentration of meat-eating dinosaurs in the world.
Meat-eating dinosaurs, eh? Well, I heard there are lots of meat-eating dinosaurs at Cleveland Lloyd, called Allosaurus. And can you tell me more about them?
Allosaurus was a late Jurassic predator. It lived about 148 million years ago and got about 30 to 35 feet long.
Why are there so many Allosaurus at Cleveland Lloyd?
We don't really know why we have so many Allosaurus at Cleveland Lloyd. But before we try to understand that question, what we really have to focus on is how this site even accumulated. How did we get so many dinosaurs here? Before we can figure out why we have so many Allosaurus, we have to fully understand everything about this site.
Sounds like a mystery. How are you trying to solve it?
We're using some new techniques in mapping the bones to understand how they're separated away from each other. We're doing that in three dimensions and in two dimensions, and we're also looking at the chemistry of the rocks and the fossils here to try to understand what this environment looked like 148 million years ago.
Cool. What were the other dinosaurs at the quarry?
Well, we have a lot of other dinosaurs here, and some of them were really, really big. We have long-necked dinosaurs like Apatosaurus, Barosaurus, and Camarasaurus. This bone right here is the shoulder blade of one of those big long-necked dinosaurs. We also have Stegosaurus and Camptosaurus. It's a rogues gallery of Jurassic dinosaurs.
So you're a paleontologist. That means you dig up bones all day, every month, every year, every second. Something like that?
Well, being a paleontologist is more than just digging up bones. A lot of the real science happens back at universities and museums and labs where we take the fossils back, clean them, restore them, and study them.
What kind of tools do you use to study those fossils that you find?
To study the fossils in the lab, we use very fine-tuned instruments like microscopes. We use dental picks and brushes and even sometimes chemicals to get off stubborn dirt.
Awesome. How did you become a paleontologist?
I've always been interested in rocks and nature, and of course, everybody likes dinosaurs.
What do you have to say for any wild explorers who are interested in your career?
If you want to be a paleontologist, you have to be willing to spend summers playing in the dirt, but also be willing to spend a lot of time reading and studying about nature and geology.
Thank you so much, Dr. Peterson.
Thanks, Cammie. See you soon.
To keep exploring, visit animaljam.com and don't forget to play wild!